Hi Anna, my name's Mark. I'm 59. I live in Lancashire and I'm a healthcare assistant at a mental health hospital. Interesting to listen to loads of amazing other contributors. Loved every one of them. Good stuff on there. Brought a tear to my eye, a few of them. They resonated. A lot of them really resonated in here. And I want to hear what people think and what they're going through because that's real news. That is the real news. Rather than listening to some robotic, trained, like news reader with an oversized desk in an empty studio and, too much hairspray in her hair. I don't want to. Why the experts all the time? Why these selected experts? I'd rather listen to everyday people. They're a damn sight more intelligent, more grounded, and they'll give you more, probably better, more reliable information than anyone on the news. I think they're all sellouts, complete sellouts. Anyway, that's my opinion of that. But I've got to keep this short because every time I seem to go over and then I can't upload the video, I can't send it. Yes, I've never, I am utterly appalled and disgusted by the level here of dishonesty and manipulation going on. I'm not into wearing masks. I don't wear masks when I go out to the shops. And so far, so good, really. Not much resistance there. I just say, look, I don't want to, if I'm challenged, I don't want to wear a mask. Don't challenge me further. I'll say, I don't believe it's good for my health. I think it's bad for my health. People are pretty good. I notice there's a lot more people around that not wearing masks. Loads more people not wearing masks when I go out to the shops than are in the shops. Okay, maybe more of them are wearing masks. Yeah, they probably just take them out of the pocket and put them on. But I'm yeah, it's empowering for me. I find it empowering when I walk out of the shop. And yeah, I didn't succumb to the wearing of something I don't really feel I should wear. I think it's like the government is making you its a little submissive serf, Gag you. New World Order. We are the underlings. Plus, I do think they're bad for your health. A lot of doctors have come out and stated many reasons why. It's sad to see. There is a supranational agenda. Absolutely 100%. Known about it for years. Agenda 21, Agenda 2030. You had the Barcelona Declaration and the Marrakesh Declaration, which all the world leaders, politician, national leaders signed up to. Of course, they didn't really tell us what it was about and what they were doing. No, because they lie. It's if they told us, we wouldn't want to wear it because it means the end of our countries and our cultures. It's beautiful. Why can't we have our countries and just trade? Good trade like we always have. No, they want the one world government so they can control all of us. It's true. It's an anti-human agenda. A lot of them are Luciferians. They do not like. Their job is to defile humanity, belittle it for Lucifer. Okay? It's to get at God. Because he can't attack God. Lucifer can't attack God directly, so he attacks what's dear to Christ or God. Yeah. And it starts to make a bit more sense. Philosophically, that argument is quite tight. Think about it. You don't have to be a believer. But a lot of people like is, it's very occultic, child sacrifice, you name it, behind the scenes of these elites. Complete disregard for humanity, a callousness and a soullessness. How can we beat it? These coming vaccinations, I don't think they're going to happen because people are waking up like you wouldn't believe. Berlin, bravo. What you did with those hundreds of thousands of people out there, it's inspiring. That's what we need to do. All we need to do is not about violence. We all get en masse, go out in a group, say, nah, not having it. And there's a damn sight more of us than you. That's all. I better cut it short there. Otherwise, there's no way I'm going to be able to upload it. But yeah, first time doing this. Thank you very much. Cheers. Bye-bye.